Voters in four states will pick their candidates in a series of races today that will narrow the field ahead of the midterm elections in November. Republicans looking to build on their majority in Congress, and Democrats eager to exploit the president's low approval rating.
Democrats have the advantage of having a unifying opposition, which Republicans had with Obama before President Trump was elected.
In the fight for control of the U.S. Senate, West Virginia and Indiana are key battlegrounds, where Republicans are hoping to nominate candidates with a good chance of defeating Democratic incumbents Joe Donnelly and Joe Manchin.
Those are two top Republican pickup opportunities.
In West Virginia, three Republicans are battling to take on Democratic Senator Joe Manchin, including former Massey Energy CEO Don Blankenship, who was convicted of a misdemeanor after the deaths of 29 men in a mine explosion. President Trump even weighed in on Monday, discouraging voters from supporting Blankenship.
I do think that Republicans are worried that Blankenship would be significantly weaker than the other two possibilities, and that he would throw away the Republicans' chances against Joe Manchin.
Looking at especially Indiana and West Virginia, we'll learn what kinds of candidates Republicans are excited about right now.
In Ohio, voters will be choosing a new governor in a heated battle on both sides to replace outgoing Governor John Kasich. And in North Carolina, there are no races for statewide office on the ballot, but a number of House seats are up for grabs.
Democrats, I think, are hoping to make some inroads in a state where the House map is clearly drawn to elect 10 Republicans and 3 Democrats to the House. But some of these districts may be vulnerable in a Democratic environment.
Overall, in November, Democrats need to pick up 23 seats to take control of the House and 2 seats to win the Senate.
One of the themes, I think, of elections held since Trump's election has been that we've seen Democratic engagement much higher. So I'm just curious to see what the turnout looks like in these states.
In Washington, Samantha Giroff, Spectrum News.